Hey everybody, Star here, what's going on? And for you guys today, I have the Soda Popper, the Atomizer, and the Winger, the full scout set being used all at once. No headgear, however, do not have the hat for it, because it doesn't really matter. From what I've been told, there are absolutely no set bonuses to anything. I hope that's true, so I didn't bother getting the hat. And here, you see me using the pistol, and that is Floppy Fish, jumping around with his rocket launcher, trying to get some market garden kills. Throughout this entire gameplay, he's going for these, where the market garden, if you're in the air and you hit somebody with that shovel, it does critical damage, which is a lot of damage. It's a pretty cool weapon, but we're going to be talking about scout stuff. So, I'm going to be pulling out the pistol in a second, the Winger. I kill the pyro really quickly here with it because he's kind of standing still. You get solid shots on somebody with this pistol, they're going to die, especially because I had crits for the first few shots there. But I get into that serious battle with the scout, not much I can do. It's still a pistol, the accuracy is terrible. It's only got 5 shots. It's all logic tells me I should never use this weapon again, because the default pistol seems, in theory, is way, way better than this thing. But something tells me, like, Star, stick with it. You might find something cool about this pistol. I mean, I like using it, I love the way it looks, and look right here, getting the crits with it, and he dies, like, immediately, because I actually get those shots on target. But at the same time, the default pistol, I think, outclasses this one a lot, but I'm going to need to spend some more time with it. It is day one. The Soda Popper builds up hype as you run around, and it builds it up incredibly quickly, way faster than I thought. From the spawn of Lakeside, Riverside, to the actual capture point, by the time you get there, you'll have hype already. So the first time you ever see anybody in that match, from when it starts, you've got hype. And, just gonna be calling out for a medic here. Hey, medic! What's this? Bam! Floppy Fish finally gets his market garden kill, and that was hilarious. I was cracking up when I saw that. Just out of nowhere, lands on the medic's head and bashes the skull in. Looking forward to doing some gameplays with those soldier items, but we're still talking about scout right now. And, you can see I got my hype filled up here. This pretty much is a force of nature. It does a little bit less damage than it, I believe, and bam, I'm dead. I'm not entirely sure how I feel about this weapon yet. I'm definitely not going to say it's better than the scattergun, because I am a scattergun fanatic. This weapon, however, it's very interesting. The best part about it, I'm still going to say, is that it makes your pistol incredibly powerful. If you're using this weapon, and no pistol is your secondary, you probably shouldn't be using it, because you're not getting the full benefit of it. The pistol with mini crits is an incredibly useful weapon, so that's what I think about that. We've also got the Atomizer, which really doesn't get used in this video because it's Harvest. Atomizer, of course, gives you the third jump, which does do 10 damage to you. A lot of controversy about that, whether or not it would do the damage to you, or you would do the damage to enemies with your third jump, which I thought made absolutely no sense, and apparently I'm right, because it does deal the damage to you. Harvest, not a very big triple jump map where it's useful. I played a couple games a little bit after this where I got some really sweet kills using it, jumping like completely around corners, like triangle jumping. It was pretty sweet. And this heavy right here has got the Atomizer. Oh my god, this weapon. I have no idea how to fight heavies using this right now. It is impressive, to say the least. Usually as a scout, you kind of have some time to get in there and get some shots on them while they're revving up their minigun. This, their minigun is completely revved up. Like, if they jump and start to spin the gun up, before they even land, they are ready to shoot. And I think you're going to see me try and battle this guy a few more times, and it just does not go my way. Atomizer is definitely the best weapon that was added during this this whole patch. And the second best, I'm going to have to say, is probably the reserve shotgun. That thing is really sweet. And here, you see me try and battle him. He just jumps, and in midair, he's already shooting this thing. And as a scout, I don't feel like it's safe to get anywhere near this guy. And I can't do very much about it. So I was trying to be very safe. Didn't go that well. But scout weapons. Oh my god, scout weapons. This shotgun is a lot of fun to play with. It has some flaws. I'm still not going to say it's better than a scattergun, but it has a unique mechanic to it, which is one of the things I was really looking forward to on a lot of these new items, because they're just different. They're new. They're something fun to play with, where if you don't feel like doing the same old thing over and over and over again, you can switch to something like this and be like, yo, I'm hype. I got hype meter. I'm so freaking pumped for this. and it's pretty cool. The pistol works well with this. I'm just gonna leave it at that. Pistol works well with this. And Atomizer, I'm not entirely sold on it yet. I know it gives you the easy triple jump, and that's a lot of fun. But Boston Basher jumping still gets you like twice the height you can from the triple jump. An example was I was playing Nucleus and trying to triple jump up to the middle capture point on Nucleus. Triple jump is not high enough in order to be able to do that. Boston Basher jumping, however, is very, very easy to get up there doing that. And of course, Boston Basher, you can help charge medic Ubers. I'm a Boston Basher fanatic, so that's my opinion. But still, it's a lot of use. You get a lot of use out of this bat because it's so easy to do. I mean, there's a couple battles later. I really wish I'd recorded everything, but I get into some battles with people and really threw them off their game by doing the triple jump and like do two jumps in the air and then I jump behind them a third time. They're like, "Yo, what's going on?" And that was pretty cool. And my chair is squeaky. So this set, I don't think it's amazing, super awesome. A couple people were saying, "Whoa, this new shotgun is so overpowered." Because every time like a scout gets in your face and you see their weapon glowing, and they kill you because of it, you're like, "Oh, crap! This gun, I hate this gun." But more often than not, I think the scout probably would have killed you anyway if they got in your face like that. Mini crits don't add that much damage, and I think the scout mentality holding this weapon when you do have the mini crits. It gives you this feeling like you have a Kritzkrieg or you have an Uber, and you, "Oh, I have to be really aggressive right now and, you know, go crazy on some people." More often than not, it seems to be getting me killed or other people get killed. You have to be kind of thoughtful of when you use it, like right here coming up behind these people. Perfect time to, you know, to get your hype. You can't really plan for it too well, though. Sometimes it just all comes together and you're like, "Yes, I am so glad I picked this." So I'm still not entirely sure what I'm going to say about it, but it is a good option. It is a very fun choice. Still not sure if it's a good choice. Well, it is a good choice, but Scattergun, I love you. Can't say anything bad about you at all. Wham! Oh, I thought he had no health because he brought out his Equalizer, and I was going to go smack him once. Of course, the Atomizer does less damage and it's slower to swing, but you could still get kills with it. I believe earlier in this video I killed a sniper and he died pretty funny. That's all I got to say for now. It was hard getting this gameplay. The first day this came out and the servers have been very laggy. Just to change your weapon was incredibly difficult. I did manage to change my weapon to the Force of Nature to confirm that yes, you can quadruple jump with the Atomizer bat and the Force of Nature blasting you up into the air. You do get the quadruple jump, which is quite cool. Still not as high as Boston Basher jumping, Hope you guys liked this video, and if anyone can help me get some of the new items to make videos about them, just lend them to me. I'll give them back to you, anything. I could probably get most of them myself, so talk to me first, but I would appreciate it, and catch you guys later.